Welcome to the channel, Excellantz'The, where we strive for excellence. We strive to be one better than what we were yesterday. Why do we do that? It's called succeeding in life. It's called rising. It's called bettering yourself. It's called making this world a better place for everyone to live. We have children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren coming behind us. Do we want them to grow up in this chaos and confusion? Or can we think of a reason to make a better resolution to this problem? Because not just America, but this whole world got a serious problem. And the serious problem is us staying in that low, in the low. That lower self, the lower realms of society. Why and how could you dare have friends and family that you would spit venom on or throw dirt on? And you throw dirt on the most precious ones. Well, it was designed that way. It has nothing to do with you. That was God's plan. See, you just going through it. One thing you got to realize, life is just an experience. It's just some shit that you go through. Because you are a spiritual being having a human experience. So we have all type of human experiences that we don't understand. But realize within yourself that that's just human. That's just part of life. It don't matter how much money you got, you will still face adversities in life. I don't care what you get. You can be rich, poor, a bum, or whatever. You still gonna experience one thing. And that thing is called life. We're going to go through that. Life, let me tell you about life. Life is a demon drop. It is a Gemini. It is a corkscrew. It is a Magnum XL 2000. It is the baddest roller coasters you can ride. Check them out. See the Point got them all. If you never heard of Cedar Point, it's in Sandusky, Ohio. If you really want to live your life to the fullest, take a trip there. But when you take that trip there, be a coaster. I remember the first time I took my daughter Diamond there, and we were coasters. We got on every roller coaster there. And you get your coaster wings. That's when fear ain't a factor. That's when you can live your life to the fullest. Live life in your times of trouble, your times of toiling. That's when you should be at your best and have joy that you're still alive and that God has blessed you with another beautiful day. We be blessed with so many beautiful days. But we have to ask ourselves, do we use them wisely or foolishly? What do we try to accomplish within the 24 hours that we have? Do we know whether we're going to wake up the next day or not? How many people didn't wake up today? And I thank God for all of you who have woken up today. It's a blessing. For everybody that I walked past today and was able to lay eyes on, thank you, God, for bringing them into my light, into my eyesight. That's just showing gratitude. You have to show gratitude towards life itself. You have to learn to appreciate the finer things in life. And the finer things are life is just being able to breathe without a mask. That's one of the finest things in life, is being able to breathe without a mask. See, they trying to mask your ass up. Don't be a cyber optic and go for the cyber bullying. Right now, you got the ones that had the coronavirus vaccine versus the ones that didn't. I mean, they trying to start all kind of wars that they are. You tell me we not in the times of Revelation. You better go back to your biblical thinking and your reasoning and understand one thing, that you didn't come here to judge nobody. You came here to try to serve your life problems out your damn self. So don't jump in my lane. It's a one-way street. And it's a tour taken by me. You don't want to go on that tour, because you don't know what kind of dark alleys I may go down or what type of shit I may be into. So don't even jump in my lane. Stay in your lane. Take your tour and go your way. And don't try to get nobody on your road with you, because then you got another car to crash into. Long as you on your journey and ain't a tree or road or a roadblock or nothing in your way, trust me, you're going to make it to your destiny. But as long as you keep looking and putting roadblocks in there by thinking, reasoning, and willing on somebody else's issues other than your own, God ain't done with me. I ain't done with myself. How the fuck you going to even try to deal with me when you can't even deal with yourself? Learn to deal with self-preservation first. That's dealing with your damn self. Solve your problems. Quit trying to judge other people. Because what God shows me, he'll never show you. And what he show you, he'll never show me. But if we put our pieces of the puzzle together, we'll see a beautiful picture. But if you keep trying to flip yours upside down when I'm trying to make mine fit yours, and if I'm trying to make mine fit yours and you trying to flip it upside down or however that shit go, you already know, because we talking parables. And a parable is something for you to figure out. So understand a man and his destiny. While you trying to create your own pathway to your own happiness and your future. You feel me? Because the gates of heaven is open, the gates of hell are open. Choose and choose wisely. But God has given the chosen ones everything it takes to save a nation. And he has told us to take it and save yourself. So one thing you must do is learn to love yourself first. Self-preservation. Damn what other people think about you. They never validate who you are. You are the one that validates yourself. A person's character speaks for itself. No one on this earth can speak for your character other than your character, because it shows. Now that's to everyone, and I came to all of y'all in love, and I'm gonna leave y'all in peace. Have a blessed night. I'm out.